Next, we'll see about the anterior surface of the coronoid process. It is rough and triangular with an elevation that is known as the ulnar tuberosity in the lower part. The entire anterior surface of the coronoid process, it receives the insertion of the brachialis muscle. The lower end of the ulnar tuberosity is connected with the corresponding part of the radial tuberosity by the oblique cord, which slopes downwards and laterally and represents the degenerated remnant of flexor pollicis longus. So here you can see the anterior surface of the coronoid process. It receives the insertion of the brachialis muscle, and then the lower end of the ulnar tuberosity gives attachment to the oblique cord. The medial margin of the anterior surface is sharp and it presents a tubercle.